So let's see practically how to converting dedicated server to shared server in Oracle database. So first we are going to discuss the first of all few of the parameters. So first parameter is shared server. So this is specify the initial number of shared servers to start and minimum number of shared servers to be keep. So whenever you want to configure the shared servers, you need to keep this parameter to non-zero values 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, 15, 20, 50, 100 like this. Maximum shared servers, it is same like this, but it is specifying the maximum number of shared server process, not more than that. So it is specifying the maximum number of shared servers that can run simultaneously. Another one is a shared server session. So basically it's specifying the total number of shared servers user session that can run simultaneously. Setting these parameters enable you to reserve the user session for dedicated server. So like if your number of sessions are 160 and if you have configured shared server sessions equal to 150, on that time the 150 connections are come with the shared servers and remaining 10s will be done with the dedicated server. Fine. Dispatchers, it is configuring the dispatcher process in the shared servers architecture. So here how many dispatchers you want to configure, that is based on the again on your connections. Maximum dispatchers, it is specifying the maximum number of dispatchers process that can run simultaneously. This is basically the both are same, but here it is defining the maximum number of dispatchers. So let's see practically. To configure the shared servers, you just need to shared servers initializations parameter to non-zero value. So this parameter is very important. These are also important, but main is this parameter. If you are setting up this parameter, remaining thing will be done by the Oracle automatically. It will also set up the dispatchers parameter also automatically, so you no need to set up. But this is the first parameter which is very important. Fine. Other parameter you no need to set it. So here if you are going with the practical, so determining the value for shared server. So what is the value you need to give this parameter? So understand this thing, the number of shared servers stabilized at the ratio of one shared server for every 10 connections. Fine. So here the important thing is that if this is basically depends on your number of connections, like if you have a 200 connections, so you can keep this parameter value shared servers equal to 20. If you have 250, then keep it 25, because it's the ratio of one shared server for every 10 connections. Fine. So this is basically show parameter equal to shared server. So we are going to see first this parameter. I connected through the PuTTY. So I'm going to show you this thing. Let me exit. So I am connected through the PuTTY to the my VirtualBox Linux machine on which I have installed the Oracle. Fine. So here what I'm doing is I'm connecting through the SQL plus SHDBA. Fine. I'm just checking the show parameter shared server. That is the value is 0. Fine. Show parameter sessions. Fine. So number of sessions are 247. The value is 247. So we can keep our shared server parameter to around 25. Fine. So first of all, we are going to change this value. Here we can see the database has a 247 set for the session parameter. So we can use this parameter shared servers equal to 25 because it is stabilized at the ratio of one shared server for every 10 connections. So here I'm just changing. First of all, I'm making the change of the shared server parameter. So here I am keeping this shared servers equal to 25, scope equal to both. Fine. Now here once you change this parameter, at this moment you can just see like how the connections are coming, how it is connected with the dedicated or shared. So at this moment, fine, all these connections are coming through the dedicated. You can see distinct server from $session. So at this moment all these sessions are connected with the dedicated. Fine. So this is the first thing you need to check. At this moment, you don't have any shared server connection. Now, the next parameter which you need to identify, that is the show parameter dispatchers. So what is the value of this parameter? The first parameter is setup. Fine. Show parameter dispatchers. So here, I am just going to see this thing, show parameter. Fine. So here dispatcher's parameter protocol TCP it is set up. So once you set up this parameter shared server equal to 25, this parameter is also set up automatically. So if it is not set up, once you bounce back the your instance, once you bounce back the instance, if it is set to null, and if you are bounce backing the instance, it will after the bounce back, it will show you dispatcher's protocol equal to TCP. This is here the already set up while I created a database. So it is, I no need to bounce back the instance, but in case, in your case, if it is not set up dispatcher equal to protocol TCP, even after changing the shared server equal to 25, you need to bounce back the instance. So this is, once you set up this parameter to non-zero value, here you can see the dispatcher equal to protocol TCP. If it is not there, just bounce back, shut down, immediate and startup. Fine. So this will, you can see dispatchers equal to protocol TCP. Now, the very important thing is that how many dispatchers you need to set up. This is by default done by the Oracle. Now, what you need to do? So here, at least one dispatcher process is required to shared server to work. Fine. At least one you require. If you enable shared server by setting up the shared servers to non-zero value, then by default, Oracle database create one dispatchers for the TCP protocol. So this is what we have done. We have set up the non-zero value for the shared servers. So Oracle has set up the one dispatchers dispatcher for the TCP protocol. Fine. Only thing is that here, in case if it is not set up, even after changing the value to the zero to non-zero, you need to bounce back the instance. So this thing you need to remember. Okay. Now determining the number of dispatchers. Assume that the one dispatcher supports the 1000 connections, and if you have 4000 connections, you can configure the four dispatchers. Fine. So at this moment we don't have that much of connections, so I'm not going to add the more dispatchers, but in case if you want to do based on your production environment, based on your connections, you can add the more dispatchers using this parameter. Fine. You can add the dispatchers equal to protocol TCP dispatcher 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Here you can add it. So at this moment, if you want to check how many dispatchers are there and what is the status of the dispatcher, we can see from this query. So here you can see we have the D00, one dispatchers we have, address TCP, OEL, port is 20195, and the status is wait. So what is the meaning of this wait status? So let's see. So here you can see the wait status, that means ideal. Send is, that is basically sending the message. Receive means receiving the message. Connect means establishing the connections. Disconnect means handling the disconnect request. Break means handling the break. Terminate, that means in the process of terminating. Accept, that means it is accepting the connections. Refuse, that means it is rejecting the connections. Fine. So these are the status of your dispatchers. So here now, after doing the configuration of dispatchers and the shared server parameter, we are going to see the practically like how the connection should be done with the shared server. Okay, so that we are going to see now. So for that, what I have done, I have installed the Oracle client on my Windows machine, and I am going to do the connectivity through the TNS, and I am going to check whether it is a shared server connection or it is a dedicated connection. So for that, first of all, you need to configure the TNS properly. So I am going to TNS. So it is already open here. So I'm just going to the admin. This is the location where I have installed the Oracle client. Okay, this is the C app path product 11.2.0 client 1. Fine. So here I am going to the tnsnames.ora file under the network admin location, and here you can see I already kept server equal to shared. In case if it is not there, you just add this line, server equal to shared. Fine. This is the line you need to edit. So once you added this line, just save this file, server equal to shared. This line you need to just add, save this, close this, and open the command from your Windows machine. Open the command from your Windows machine. This is the PuTTY connectivity. This is what I have done. This is the my PuTTY connectivity to the my Linux machine. This is the Windows machine command prompt. So now I am just accessing the SQL plus. This is the, I am basically doing the client connectivity. So here I am connecting with the Scott at ORCL. Fine. and giving the password. So here you are connected to the ORCL, @ORCL. So what is the @ORCL under the TNS names? It is connecting to the 192.168.56.10. This is the machine 192.168.56.10, and that is the 1521 port, listener port is there, 1521, service name is ORCL, and the server is shared. So whether this is done, the shared server or dedicated server. So now we are going to check. Once the connection is done from your client machine, fine, if you are checking the, like, how many tables are there, T names from tab. So you are just checking the describe to the tab, like everything is working fine or not. T name from tab, you can see these are the tables we have on the our Scott user. Now what we are going to check here is how the connections are done, dedicated or shared. So what you need to check, fine, you need to check the distinct server from $session, fine. So here if I am checking this onto the my PuTTY connectivity, through the my PuTTY connectivity, distinct server from $session, that is showing the none. What is the meaning of none? So dedicated is already there, but the new connection done with the none. None means it is a shared server connections, but at this moment there is no request, there are no long activity done by the Scott user from the client machine, that's why it is showing you the none. But the meaning of the none, that means it is dying with the shared server. So can we check the user, which user is connected with the shared? So you can just do the username comma server from $session. So here you can see username comma server from $session, where server equal to where username equal to Scott. Our Scott user is there connected. So it is, see, it is showing none. None means it is a shared server. If Scott is doing lots of activity, lots of lengthy activity, then it will show you the server equal to shared. Fine. So in this way, you can convert your database from dedicated to shared. Fine. This is the, we have tested from the our client machine that connections are done from the Scott user, connection is done from the Scott user with as a shared server. And if you want to revert back from the shared server to dedicated, you need to do the changes from shared server parameter to zero, dispatchers to null, and also change the TNS entry, find server equal to dedicated, in case if you want to revert back shared to dedicate. And for dedicated to shared, two parameters required. One is shared server and another one is your dispatchers. Fine, dispatchers automatically, if you are setting up this to the non-zero value, it will automatically change dispatchers to the your, at least it will configure the one dispatchers if you are setting up non-zero value. But for that, you need to bounce back the database. Fine, so this thing you need to just keep it in your mind. So here we have seen like how to convert dedicated to shared in Oracle database. Thank you.